start from source string to destination using the string instruction. Okay. So 6, 5A. Now we have a string which we are going to transfer. It is microprocessor lab. So we are going to transfer this string to destination. So first thing you need to know that in string related instructions, all the source will be pointed by data segment, whereas the destination, which you are going to transfer the destination, right, that will be pointed by an extra segment. So whatever you transfer, the source string, whatever you transfer, that should be transferred to the extra segment. In all other programs, normally whatever you transfer, both source and destination will be a part of data segment. But here in string related instructions, the source will always be pointed by a data segment, whereas destination will be always pointed by an extra segment. That is very important. Okay. Now the second important point is, an extra segment is a part of data segment. Extra segment is a part of data segment. So the memory required for an extra segment will be given by the processor randomly by default. We are not going to define any memory for extra segment. The memory for the extra segment will be defined by the processor by default randomly. It generates some memory in a part of data segment and it says that that part of the memory is an extra segment. Okay. Now we need to know the length of this source string if we are going to transfer. So let me calculate length. So I am going to write this in decimal. So the total string length is 18 including space. Okay, including space is 18. Now if I go with hexadecimal, the length is A, B, C, D, E, F, 10, 11, 12. 12H is the length of the string in an hexadecimal, whereas the total length of this particular string is 18 in decimal. Okay. Now, the program is written here to transfer this entire string to destination. It will not transfer entire string at a time to destination. The transfer will happen byte by byte. First it will transfer M and then it will transfer I and then C and then R and then O and so on. Now, whenever you try to store the string in the data segment, it will not store this alphabet. The ASCII value of that particular alphabet will be stored in the data segment. Okay, so you should know that ASCII value of small a to small a will always start from 61 in an hexadecimal, 61 to 66. If I take from a to f, as this is a source string and this is a string which is a group of alphabets, we can have more than f. Why am I worried about a to f? Because hexadecimal ranges from a to f, right, after 9. Whereas here we have many other characters also, so therefore it just continues. F for the, what is G? 67 and so on. If it is a small character, if I give a capital letter, the capital A starts from 41. Okay, so capital A starts from 41 and it continues 41, 42, 43 till Z. So 26 different characters will have 26 continuous values after 41, 42 and so on. Okay, so these ASCII values are the values which get stored in the memory, and that is what you see in the debugger screen. Okay, you see the ASCII value of M, I, C, R, O in the memory of the data segment wherever you go and try to see the input, right? So there you see these ASCII values of these characters. Okay, now how do we transfer the source string to the destination? That is our point. Now which is the string related instruction which can be used to do this job? Okay, so we have 5 string related instructions in an 8086: move SP, compare SP, scan SP, store SP and load SP. Understood? So we have move SP, scan, store, compare and then load. Now which would be the instruction which is very which is good enough to be used for this particular program or for this particular algorithm which I am defining? So the best instruction which you can use here is move SP. Okay, so move SP will do what? It moves the content of source to destination. Okay, so it moves the content of source which is pointed by data segment to the destination which is pointed by the extra segment. Understood. So therefore, MOVSB is the main instruction which you need to know in this program. Okay, I'll tell you the program part. Okay. So MOVSB will do what? It doesn't move the entire string to destination. It only moves one particular byte. MOVSB means what? Move string byte. Understood? Move string byte means what? It only moves one single byte to destination. If I want all these particular characters to be pushed to the destination, what should I do? I should use one more string related instruction, which is very important, which is actually repeat. Okay? Now what is REP? REP will do what? It will try to move all the bytes until your CX, if it is 16 bit, and if your 8 bit, it is CL, will become 0. Okay? So it keeps on moving string byte from source to destination until the particular register CX becomes 0. Now what should be the value of CX then? So the length of the string will be equal to the value of CX. Right? So we need to know how many bytes should be pushed to the destination. Therefore we know that we have totally 80 number of characters. Therefore CX should be loaded with 80. Okay, so that is what we are doing in the program. Got it? We load CX with 18 and yet once CX becomes 0, it means that you have pushed all the bytes in the source to destination. Okay, so let us go back to the program part. So the first part or the first line of the program is what? So the first line is data segment, and then we are going to say SRC. I will use this variable name. This is a name used for a variable to define a variable. You can try to write anything you want. You can write SORC or SRC or anything. I have used SRC to say that it is a source string. Understood? You can give your name also if you want. Any name can be given. But see through that what name you give. There should be a meaning for that. So I use SRC because it is a source string. So it's a source. Understood? Source string. All character in the string is of byte length, right? One byte. Each is of one byte. Therefore, the data type will go with DB. Okay? Data byte. And then I'll try to put the entire string within a single quoted mark. And that says it is a string. Now, if you don't put a single quoted mark, it takes only M in the particular microprocessor there. And it will not take the entire string. Okay, so when you are trying to take entire string into consideration, you should see through that the entire string will be covered with this single quoted mark. Now if you don't put this mark, your computer will be confused whether I am looking into a string or what. It will never understand, because it will never see the ASCII value of the character section. Only if you put the single quoted mark, you can see that ASCII value gets stored in the computer, and your computer will be able to understand what is M with that value only. Okay? It understands, it sees the ASCII value, and then it understands that the value says that it is the character M. Understood? So therefore, I need to end this string, right? I have to end this string, so I'll put comma, and then I'll try to put this dollar. Anyway, for this program, the dollar is not required, because the next part of this particular code is, we are not giving any message or something, right? We are not giving any other string in the next line of the code. So you can remove that dollar if you want. Okay, it is not necessary to write the dollar symbol. Now the next line of the code was what? I am going to calculate the length of the source. So I write LEN, and then wherever you are calculating the length, okay, you see through that you are going to subtract the dollar minus the variable name that you have given to represent the source. Always, anywhere you are going to calculate the length of the string, you are going to try to put that dollar minus SRC. But what this value is? Is it a constant or what? What is the length value? It is a constant value, right? 18 is a constant, right? You can't change the length, because if you are going to change the length, you should change the string length also. Means you should add some more characters into this. As my string is fixed for 18 is the length of the string, so this will be remained as constant only. You can't change it. For that, what I am going to add here after the LEN is EQU. EQU says it's a constant value. You cannot change it. Okay, so that is anything else to be there in the data segment? I have given the source to be pushed to the destination. I have mentioned what is the length value of the source. Now, my next part is I need to define the destination where this particular source to be transferred. So that will not be happened in data segment. That will be happened in extra segment. Therefore, I say data ends. I will go with extra segment definition now. Extra segment. So I am going to define the memory for storing the destination, right? So I will just use a variable called DES, for example. So DES says it is destination. You can use any name, as I said, you for source, whatever we have defined. DES, and then I will again say DB, right? Because whatever I am transferring is what? It's byte-wise. Therefore, the data type for even destination is again data byte only. I don't know what is the source that is getting transferred. Until and unless it transfers, I don't know what is the source, that particular source you are going to transfer. So for that, I'll just define some length here. As I can see, the source length is 18 in decimal. I'll just say 20 or 22. You can even define 18 if you want, nothing wrong. Okay. I'll just take one more or two more extra compared to the source length. Okay. So this value says that you are defining so much amount of memory to store the data which you are going to transfer from source to destination. Understood? And I don't know what is the data I am going to transfer. So I will just use DUP question. Okay. So it is doing what? It is trying to define duplicate. DUP is duplicate. It is trying to duplicate 22 bytes of location in destination so that the source can be transferred to that particular location, whatever you are going to define. If you don't define this value 22, your computer or your processor will never able to understand what is the destination length. So it mismatches. There will be an error which causes, what error is, it is not a syntax error which you can see, it will be a logical error. What is a logical error? It gets confused, what would be the source, that source length, I don't know. So destination length you have not defined. So what should I do? So it keeps quiet. It just takes some random memory length and it tries to define. So there is no proper way of structuring the proper structure of seeing the output if you don't define the memory. Okay. So size should be defined, it is must end. Now what else is there in the extra segment? That's it. So I have defined the location for the destination. This program is just to move a source from destination, you know, source to destination. So that's it. So extra ends. Okay, I hope these two things are fine. So let me go with the next further. This is the data segment definition, extra segment definition. The next definition is our code segment, right? So let me go with the code segment now. So code segment should start from this keyword code segment. Assume CS port and DS data, and then you should also put one more, which is ES extra. This comes only for string related programs, whatever you have. Then you are going to start the program. The two lines will initialize the data segment. And another two lines will initialize the extra segment. As we have seen, both data and extra which is defined earlier, so we need to initialize both the segments here. Now, I need to point out, I need to tell in the code where you need to go and take its source string from. Right? I need to tell in the code where should I go and take the source string from. That is done by the next instruction, LEN SI, source. Okay? So, this line says load effective address of the source to SI. Means you should always point out by using this instruction. So this instruction says whatever the value that is being stored in SI, that is the starting memory, that is the base address of the source that is getting stored in the data segment. Okay. So when I say LESI, source, base address is being stored to SI. Okay. Now what would be the base address in the program? If you see in the data segment, the base address would be 0000 because we haven't defined org 1000h or something like that, right? So therefore the base address will always start from, by default it is 0000. Okay. Anyway, I also need to say LDADI comma destination. So here I should also say my processor that where should I go and see the destination string and where it is actually transferred. Okay. So whatever DI gets stored is the base address of the destination where the string is getting stored. Understood? Now you know what is SI, but you don't know what is DI. The reason is I told you destination is a part of extra segment, where extra segment address will be given randomly by your processor by default. You are not going to define. Whereas source will always begin from 0000 if you haven't given it by default. Understood? Now after this is what? Move CX comma length. So I have already defined an equation in data segment to calculate the length, right? So I need not to say move CX comma 18 here. I will say move CX comma LEN, and LEN gives you the value 18. Okay, so that is loaded to CX. What else should be there in the program? Move? No, what is the next part of the program that you have? So why you are clearing the direction flag? We clear the direction flag. I said you long back. Direction flag is the one which automatically, okay, by default increments or decrements the content of SI and DI. When the direction flag is set, your SI and DI will be decremented by 1 if it is a byte operation and decremented by 2 if it is a word operation. Similarly, when direction flag is 0, means if it is reset, your SI and DI will be incremented by 1 if it is a byte operation, or it will be incremented by 2 if it is a word operation. So that is very important. So I am clearing the direction flag because I need an increment, not decrement. So if I want to go from M with the I here, if I want to go from M to I, what should I do? I should increment SI, right? I should not decrement. Therefore, clearing the direction flag will automatically increment SI and DI. Understood? So after clearing the direction flag, my next job is what? Move SB, right? So I'll just say move SB. So this is, I'm sorry, this entire move SB is one single line. You should not leave space between move and SB. Okay. Therefore, move SB will do what? It will move only M to the destination. Understood? If I want I to be moved to the destination after M, I will add REP. So REP will do what? So clearing the direction flag will increment the SI and DI by default. Every repetition SI and DI is been incremented because the direction flag is 0. Understood? So repeat move SB will do what? First it will move M and then I and then C and then R and then O. So SI and DI is been incremented by default because of the direction flag is being cleared. Therefore, this will continuously push the entire string to destination. That's it. This is the end of the program. So our program is what? Try to transfer source from source to destination. Right? So that is over. So the next line would be what? Int 3 and then code ends and start. Okay? Either you can use int 3 and you can also use move age comma 4ch and int 21. This is not a display program. See that int21h is required only if you are doing some DOS related programs. Okay, when you are displaying some message or if you are displaying some character on the DOS screen. Okay, if such type of programs is there, always it is better to use at the termination level, you use that move h, 4ch, int21h. But this is just moving the source to destination. So int3 is sufficient. Int3 says it is a breakpoint. Means that is the end of your code. And all other code that you can see in the debugger screen is a junk code. Understood? You will have a junk code, right? In the debugger screen you have seen plenty of times. So this breakpoint will say that this is only the part of your code which you are going to break. Understood? Fine?